My name is Lucia dos Santos. When I was 10 years old, an extraordinary event changed my life forever. I was touched by the supernatural and blessed with a secret. A secret I have kept without reservation. My superiors have now asked me to write it all down. The memory stored in my heart. It was 1917. The innocence of the world was fading. Kings had been shot, and brothers fought against brothers. It was also a time of revolution. In Russia, the Bolsheviks were preparing to seize power. They had declared the church an enemy of the people, and their words spread like poison in the hearts of men. In Portugal, the monarchy had been overthrown and replaced with a republican government, intent on the elimination of all religion within 2 generations.
May God forgive you, Arturo dos Santos.
But in Fatima, it seemed for us, we were lucky. Our lives went on almost as normal.
Yes!
Father owned a large plot of land, the Cova de Iria. As my brothers and sisters before me, I came to an age when it became my duty to look after our sheep. All the village children worked as I did, often grazing their flocks together. They always asked me to come and join them. But I preferred my own company. Although, 2 of the children usually made a point of coming to find me. My young cousins, Jacinta and Francisco. Jacinta wanted to be my little helper, and always insisted her devoted brother come with her to join me in the fields. They were inseparable.
Well, as long as you know we won't be playing games all day.
Francisco was a gentle boy. He always did as his little sister asked. never protesting or becoming impatient with her. He was a quiet and sensitive soul, very like his father, thoughtful and compassionate. And not at all like our little Jacinta, who just had to be the center of attention. If she didn't get what she wanted, she would sulk until we gave in.
Are you going to sit there all day?
Probably.
That's the one thing that could always distract her and lighten her mood. She loved to dance. And Francisco loved to play for her. This is how life was for us. Until the 13th of May. First, we thought a storm was coming. It was as though the whole world was holding its breath. Afraid. I am from heaven. I could feel her love wash over me, like a wave. She asked us if we would be willing to suffer for God, for our suffering would save so many sinners. When we said yes, the light of heaven pierced my heart and filled my soul. We agreed between us that we shouldn't speak of this to anyone. But Jacinta was so overcome. Her enthusiasm was too much.
Jacinta, stop! You mustn't tell anyone!
She just had to talk about the Lady of Light.
What lady?
Not just any lady. Our Lady. And she appeared right in front of them. A sign from heaven.
I didn't say it's Our Lady.
Lucia, what is this all about? Lucia? Lucia?
Sure, Mama. We saw her come from heaven, and she was so beautiful, Mama.
It is blasphemy. That is what it is. I don't know how you could make up such lies.
If Francisco and Jacinta say they saw something at the cover, then I believe them.
You can believe what you like. But I tell you, these lies will bring the wrath of God down upon our heads. I don't know what you're playing at, my girl, but you will stop this nonsense right now, before it gets out of hand. Do you hear me?
But it's true.
Do you hear me?
It's true,
no,
Mama.
Stop lying. Stop lying.
It's true.
Stop it. Stop it, Lucia.
Mama, it's true, Mama.
Maria. Maria.
Have I the only one with any sense around here?
Come on, children.
As if I don't have enough to worry about without my youngest making up such things.
Maybe she did see a beautiful lady floating in the sky.
This is all your fault. I have told you about filling their heads with silly fairy stories. Father Ferrara will know what to do. I shall take her to him first thing.
You say this woman spoke with you?
Yes, Padre.
What did she say?
She told us not to be afraid.
And did she say anything else?
From the start, I was inspired by the lady to answer so that I neither lied nor revealed the thing she wanted us to keep secret. I told them. She said we should pray the rosary every day, and that she had asked us to return at the same hour of the 13th day of every month for 6 months.
And she'll perform a miracle, so I talk with you.
I don't know why she is making up such wicked lies, Padre. She has always been such a good child.
I'm not making it up, Padre, I'm not.
Padre. Surely you do not believe that the Virgin Mary appeared to these children?
I believe she saw something. That it was indeed of supernatural origin, but I do not believe it was a revelation from heaven. It is usual in such cases for our Lord to tell those to whom he makes such communication to give, well, to a confessor or a parish priest an account of what has happened, but with this child, on the contrary, she keeps as much as she can to herself.
Father Ferreira's final words filled me with terrible doubts.
She's always been such a good child.
I'm not making it up.
I believe she saw something. I do not believe it was a revelation from heaven.
It's the devil.
Every night, my dreams were plagued by those doubts and fears. And my days were filled with torment.
If it's not the little saint herself, which more like?
There's so many saints and angels in the house. It's a wonder the children can get in.
And in the weeks that followed, the world that I had known slowly turned against me.
Don't you see her, Lucia? A lady floating above your house. Don't you see?
What makes you so special, Lucia de Soto?
She gets it from her mother. They used to burn people.
these lies will bring the wrath of God down upon our heads.
They used to burn people like you at the stake.
I said I would never go back there. However much my cousins pleaded with me, I'd made up my mind. I would not see her anymore. But on the day that she said she would return, I felt myself drawn back to the cova, like a moth to a flame. She was so beautiful, so good. I had to return. I had to see her face again and feel the love in her smile. And where are you going?
East, the 13th.
You really believe those children?
What if it's true, Lily? I'll be home for supper.
You'll be the only one there. You silly old fool. I asked her what it was that she wanted of me. She said for me to pray the rosary for peace. And then she told me that I must learn to read and write. For I would make her message known. to the world. From that day on, more and more people came to the Cova. Some looking for cures, others to ask us questions. All of them with faith rekindled in their hearts. And with this renewed faith came a courage that had not surfaced before. They built a shrine at the Cova. A beacon of hope to be seen by all.
Fires of superstition can do terrible damage if not contained.
I fully understand the seriousness of the situation. I assure you of that.
Of course. We have great faith in you, Arturo.
How dare you come into this house smelling of drink?
I've had one drink.
Don't lie to me.
All right. I had a few drinks. I've been talking business.
Business? What kind of business?
With Sancho Gatresh.
We can do without help from the likes of him.
I went to the Cova today. Everything has been trampled by the crowds. Or eaten by the animals. Sancho said he could help us.
Help himself, more like. We can manage without his kind of help.
Is this the house of Lucia dos Santos? Please. My husband and I have walked all the way from Porto.
These people give us no rest.
Please.
When will it be enough?
Please.
When you have taken every item of her clothing, every lock of her hair.
Please.
I want you help
us. I can't take much more of this. Why is she doing this to us? I just can't understand why she is doing this to us.
Take her to see the priest again.
I'll take a broom handle to her, that's what I'll do. I'll beat those wicked lies out of her once and for all. So help me God, I will.
I wanted to tell my mother that it wasn't true, to ease her fears. But from the cradle, she had taught us that above all, we must always tell the truth. And I remembered how the lady had told me that she would be my comfort and my strength. The day my sister left, I held on to those words, even as I felt my heart breaking.
Mom has found the work for me, as a servant, for a rich family. She said we need the money. We don't have enough to eat.
Hurry up, or we'll be late.
From now on, if you want something to eat, you can eat what grows at the cover.
Offered my suffering to God and thought of all the souls that I was saving.
Well, I think it is a pity for them.
Maria Santos. She likes to give herself airs. Now she's a laughing stock. Serves her right.
And have you seen the state of their land? Ruined. So many feet trampling. Crops all gone, you know.
And what did you see? No.
It was difficult. So many people. But I heard a tiny voice. Like music. Maybe next time.
If there is a next time, they say the government will send men to block the roads. Soldiers with guns. Maybe cannons.
Cannons. They say all sorts. Doesn't mean it's true.
Maria from the mill says her aunt could barely hobble there with the pain in her bad leg. But she skipped. All the way home.
That was the wine.
You can't say that.
No, it's true. She had a bad sore. Now it's completely dry. I told everybody. My sister-in-law told her cousins. Next time, there will be so many people, they won't dare stop us. If those little children aren't afraid to go, then neither should we.
The apparition of the 13th of July was different. The lady appeared just as she had before. But this time, there was a sadness about her. And when she opened her hands, it was not heaven's warmth that embraced us. City, half in ruin, and said that unless people turn to God, he will punish the world with a second world war within the next generation. To prevent this, she would come back to ask for the Pope to consecrate Russia to her immaculate heart. If then we still did not act on her requests, godless men will spread their communism throughout the world, causing war, famine, and persecutions of the church. The good will be martyred. The Holy Father will have much to suffer. We saw an angel shouting, "Penance, penance, penance." He pointed the swords towards the earth, as if to set the world on fire. But the flames were stopped by the splendor that Our Lady radiated towards him. She said, "In the end, her immaculate heart will triumph, and a period of peace will be granted to the world."
That's my daughter.
You're going
home. What did you say? What did you tell you?
What's happened?
What did you say? What did you tell you?
These crowds, they are dangerous. A powder keg. A few rabble-rousers. A voluble cleric. And we could have a riot on our hands. That would not look good for me in Lisbon. Do we understand each other? Certain.
The children, they need to answer some questions in the public interest.
For the records,
which must be thorough. We have worked too long for the priests to undermine us with more fairy tales.
But no violence. I want no martyrs here.
The things we had seen had changed us. Francisco became even more withdrawn from the world, and even Jacinta preferred solitude to the continual questions we had now come to endure. So we spent our days up in the hills, hiding from the world. But we could not hide forever. Morning of the next apparition, the administrator, Señor de Oliveira Santos, came looking for us. He said he wanted to take us to see Father Ferreira, who had questions for us all.
This won't take long. And when we're done, I'll take you to the cova myself. That way you'll avoid all the crowds on the roads, And besides, I'd like to see one of these monthly miracles with my own eyes. And maybe I'll believe too. Just like Thomas,
He did not take us to Father Ferreira. He took us back with him to the government headquarters in Oran.
Come with me. Come on.
You three have caused quite a stir. Must be exciting. to have your names in the newspapers, hmm? You don't look excited. You look frightened. Well, you should be. Thousands of people are probably standing in a field right now, waiting for some kind of miracle to happen. How do you think they will feel when nothing happens, hmm?
Please, Signor, you must let us go. You must. We promise her.
Yes. The lady that floats in the sky, hmm? Is it true? This lady confided a secret to you.
Yes, Signor.
What was it?
Can't tell you, Signor. We promise not to tell anyone.
You think this is some sort of game? Withholding important information from the government is an offense punishable by death.
I lost the lady, Signor. And if she gives permission, I will tell you.
Permission? Maybe if I tell you how you will die, it will loosen your tongues. There is a cauldron out back, filled with boiling oil. You will be lowered into the cauldron, slowly. An inch at a time, the flesh will be boiled off your bones. I will tell you what I'm going to do. I will give you a little time to think over the seriousness of your situation.
Make yourselves at home.
Everyone is talking about? Children of Fatima, they're supposed to hear messages from heaven. They have put you in one place in the whole of Portugal where no one can hear your prayers.
Jacinta, didn't the lady say that we all have to suffer much? Think of all the souls we'll save. Don't cry. Don't be afraid.
Do any of you ladies know how to dance?
Jacinta as she was that day. Afraid, with tear-stained cheeks, and dancing.
I'm supposed to run this way.
It doesn't matter. There is nowhere else I'd rather be.
Stop that now, or there will be trouble. And you? Shouldn't you be praying?
This day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
There are some who say that Our Lady came down to the holm oak in the form of a small blue cloud, and finding we were not there, rose again to heaven.
Look, Lucia. Look at the lamps of the angels shining brightly in the sky.
Are they really the lamps of the angels?
Of course. And the moon? That is the lamp of Our Lady.
It's so beautiful.
Too far.
cannot let Arturo get away with this.
Arturo is very powerful.
God, hear me. Do something now.
No! Get the children!
What chance have we against rifles and guns? Hmm? Go home.
Do something now. We can take them. We are many. We are strong.
Go back to your home, all of you.
Why don't you just tell them this secret? And then they will let you go home.
I'd rather die.
Is it something good or something bad, this secret?
Good for some. And bad for others.
You sweep. Come with me. Come on.
Well? Well, what is it to be? I have tried to save you. But as you won't cooperate, there is nothing else I can do. Guard, is the oil good and hot?
Boiling.
Take the little one and throw her in. What kind of boy are you, hmm? To allow your sister to go to such a death?
I'm Mary. Full of grace. The Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed the fruit of your womb. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and the hour of our death.
She's fried.
I'm not afraid to die. I'm not afraid. I'm not afraid.
It will be you next, Lucia. Unless you tell me the secret. And admit it was all lies, hmm?
Or rather die.
Very well. You shall.
I no longer felt any fear for myself. Only joy that I would soon be going to heaven.
You're afraid to go.
We were free. Free to return home. There was no welcome for me there. In October, the rains came. My mother said it was heaven's way of putting an end to childish nonsense. But to me, it was the tears of the angels. Weeping for all those who would never believe. And I prayed that the miracle the lady had promised us would be big enough for the whole world to see.
With Santos.
Can't you guess?
Oh, a reporter.
So, what do you really think? Is it make-believe or divine inspiration?
I think it is God's will.
God's will? Not just children's imaginings, then.
No, senor. I do not imagine.
No?
My Lucia does not lie. Her cousins do not lie.
You must understand, I have to question these things.
You and every other outsider who comes here thinking they know best. My crops are ruined. The cover is ruined. Every day, more and more people swarm onto my land like locusts. My family is suffering.
And you resent this favoritism of God's?
It is pointless to resent what is out of our hands.
I see them. The little seers?
Really?
In jail. They came and prayed with us.
The government doesn't want us poor people knowing about the greatness of Our Lady.
Now we heard that they are planning to throw bombs at the crowd this time.
Who says?
Lots of people.
But you're still going.
Oh, senor. There is going to happen a miracle. Who wouldn't risk his life for a miracle?
Very sure.
Senor, I have talked to the children, the little seers. I believe them.
They converted you.
They opened my eyes.
And I thought it was sheep pens you were in for opening. I don't mind you asking questions, especially while you're buying wine. But everyone here is simply a gullible peasant.
You don't share his optimism.
I believe what I can see with my eyes, touch with my hands.
So, you're not going to the coffin?
Of course I am. We all are. They say 100,000 may come. Would you want your grandchildren to ask about a miracle in your village? And you have to tell them I wasn't there.
And if there is no miracle?
Could it be that all of this is God's will? In punishment for my sins?
Is all God's work, then praise be to God.
I've been told more than once today. What will happen if nothing happens tomorrow?
I do not think they'll harm the children.
How do you know what they're capable of?
Look, why don't you stay here tomorrow? I will go with the children.
This is not about you proving what a big hero you are, Timarto.
No. It's about proving what kind of father I am.
I'm going with you.
Could it be that all of this is God's will? In punishment for my sins?
It's about proving what kind of father I am.
Lucia, come. It's time to get you ready. Come. If you must go, I will go and die with you.
We will each be judged for our actions this day. You should not have let the children go. Lambs amongst wolves.
What if she doesn't come today? What if she won't come anymore?
She promised.
Show us the sign! Show us the sign!
We have been cheated!
We have all allowed ourselves to be deceived!
You have made fools of us! The parents are to blame.
Are you proud of your lying children?
Making the rain stop. That'd be a good sign.
Little fools, they're laughing at you.
Little fake. Is that what you think they are now?
I told you it wasn't true. It's all rubbish.
Whoever wants to go can go. But I'm not. Our lady told us to come. She'll be here soon.
Raining.
What do you want from me?
Of all the things said to us that day, what impressed me most deeply was her tender sorrow. She said that we must turn to God, for he is already so much offended. She spoke so gently, but with so much pain. I wanted to spread her words throughout the whole world.
Will she take us to see heaven? I want so much to see heaven.
She told me that she would take Francisco and Jacinta to heaven very soon, but I would have to stay.
Am I to stay here alone?
She told me not to be afraid, for she would be with me always.
We have been cheated! We have been cheated!
Of the rosary. You promised a miracle. Will you show them a sign so that people will believe?
Thank you.
They say 70,000 people saw the sun dance that day. And my whole world changed forever. Always there were people. Always questions. Everybody wanted to meet the little seers. To pray with them. To ask them for Our Lady's help. We became curiosities. It was not long before heaven kept its promise to my cousins. After the war, the influenza came. I do not remember how many weeks Francisco suffered, but he never complained. Not once. He took his flight to heaven on the 4th of April in 1919. Jacinta joined him a year later.
Don't cry, Papa.
Her final sacrifice to Our Lady was to die alone in a hospital in Lisbon on the 20th of February.
Tell me, Mama.
I am told that there is a language in which the word Fatima means peace. It is my hope that Fatima will remain always a light in the dark. A light that will lead us to peace.
With you by my side.